Hello children, I feel very happy to take class for you during this quarantine, and also I hope you that you are all well and good. Today's lesson is current electricity, and its subtopic is temperature coefficient of electricity, energy and power, electric cells and batteries.
Temperature dependence of resistivity. The resistivity of a material is dependent on temperature. It is experimentally found that for a wide range of temperatures, the resistivity of a conductor increases with temperature. That means increased temperature, the resistivity will be increases. According to the expression, rho T is equal to rho naught 1 plus alpha T minus T naught, derivative number 2.27, where rho T is the resistivity of a conductor at T degree Celsius. Rho naught is the resistivity of a conductor at some reference temperature T naught, usually at 20 degree Celsius. And alpha is the temperature coefficient of resistivity. Children, it is very important 2-mark question. Note down. It is defined as the ratio of increase in resistivity per degree rise in temperature to its resistivity at T naught temperature. From the derivative 2.27, we can write rho T minus rho naught is equal to alpha rho naught T minus T naught. Therefore, alpha is equal to rho T minus rho naught by rho naught into T minus T naught is equal to delta rho by rho naught into delta T, where rho, that means delta rho is equal to rho T minus rho naught is the change in resistivity. For a change in temperature, delta T equal to T minus T naught. Its unit is per degree Celsius. Children, it's also very important 1-mark question. That means unit of temperature dependence of resistivity. Alpha of conductors. For conductors, alpha is positive. If the temperature of a conductor increases, the average kinetic energy of electrons in the conductor increases. The results in more frequent collisions, and hence the resistivity increases. The graph is given clearly. The resistivity increases for increasing the temperature. Even though the resistivity of a conductors like metals varies linearly for wide range of temperatures, there also exists a non-linear region at very low temperatures. The resistivity approaches some finite values or value as the temperature approaches absolute zero, which is given in the diagram. We can understand clearly. As the resistance is directly proportional to resistivity of the material, we can also write the resistance of a conductor at the temperature T degree Celsius as RT is equal to R naught 1 plus alpha T minus T naught 2.28, the derivative. It's very important derivative for solving the problem. Keep in our mind, children, it's very, very important, frequently asking derivative. We go to the diagrams. The temperature increases, resistivity is increases for non-conductors. The temperature coefficient can also be obtained from the equation 2.28. RT minus R naught is equal to alpha R naught T minus T naught. Therefore, alpha is equal to RT minus R0 by R0, or T minus T0 is equal to 1 by R0 delta R by delta T. Therefore, temperature coefficient of conductor alpha is equal to 1 by R0 delta R by delta T. It's also very important relation, very important derivative, very important formula for problems, where delta R is equal to RT minus R0 is the change in resistance during the change in temperature. That means delta T is equal to T minus T naught. Now we are entering alpha of semiconductors. For semiconductors, the resistivity decreases with increase in temperature. As the temperature increases, more electrons will be liberated from their atoms. We will study clearly at lesson number 9. Hence, the current increases and therefore the resistivity decreases. A semiconductor with a negative temperature coefficient of resistance is called thermistor. You should understand, children, thermistor. The typical values of temperature coefficient of various material is given in the table. Where is the table? We'll see the table. The table is given different materials and also their temperature coefficient. Maybe one more question. We can understand the temperature dependence of resistivity in the way or in the following way. That means we have shown that the electrical conductivity sigma is equal to n e square tau by m. As the resistivity is inverse of sigma, it can be written as rho is equal to m by n e square tau. 2.30 derivative number, already we seen previous topics. So therefore, the resistivity of material is inversely proportional to the number of density of the electron, inversely proportional to the average time between the collisions of the electron, simply tau. In the metals, if the temperature increases, the average time between the collision decreases and n is independent of the temperatures. In some semiconductors, when temperature increases, n increases and tau decreases, but increase in n is dominant than decreasing the tau, that means time, so that overall resistivity will be decreases. Children, you should understand that. Do you know? If you want more knowledge, you can go through it. And also, if you want more clear about resistivity, temperature dependence of resistivity, you should solve the problem 2.13 and also 2.14. these problems are like a key for us to understand the concept. Let us go next topic: energy and power in electrical circuits. When a battery is connected between the ends of a conductor, a current is established. The battery is transporting energy to the device which is connected in the circuit. Consider a circuit in which a battery of voltage V is connected to the resistor as shown in the figure. Children, see that diagram clearly. Battery is there, resistor is there, from which we should understand energy given by battery. Assume that a positive charge of dq moves from point A to B through the battery and moves from point C to D through the resistor and back to the point A. When the charge moves from point A to B, it gains potential energy. That means dU is equal to V into dQ. And the chemical potential energy of the battery decreases by the same amount. When this charge dQ passes through a resistor, it loses the potential energy. dU is equal to V into dQ. Due to collisions with atoms in the resistor and again reaches the point A, this process occurs continuously till the battery is connected in the circuit. The rate at which the charge loses its electrical potential energy in the resistor can be calculated. So the electrical power P is in the rate at which the electrical potential energy is delivered. P is equal to dV by dt. D by dt into VQ into dQ is equal to V into dQ by dt. Since the electrical current relation is I is equal to dQ by dt, so the equation 2.31 can be written as P is equal to VI. The power relation is P is equal to VI, very important relation. This expression gives the power delivered by the battery to any electrical system, where I is the current passing through it and V is the potential difference across it. The SI unit of electrical power is watt. Commercially, the electrical bulbs used in houses come with the power and voltage rating of 5 watt 220 volt, 30 watt 220 volt, 60 watt 220 volt and etc. If you want to buy the bulb, you should ask like this. Now we will see that bulbs. The bulbs are given by watt with volts. We should understand that. If you want to buy the bulb, you should ask the shopkeeper watt with volt. Electrical bulbs with the power. Now we entering the another mechanism is children also we should understand the power. Usually these voltage rating refers AC RMS voltages. For a given bulb, if the voltage drops across the bulb is greater than the voltage rating, the bulb will fuse. Using Ohm's law, the power delivered to the resistance R is expressed in other forms. P is equal to IV is equal to I into IR, simply I square R. So simply P is equal to IV is equal to V into V by R, simply V square by R. These are all the relation of power in different forms or in different forms. Children, you should understand that. Do you know the electrical power produced? You should understand by reading that. The total energy used by any device is obtained by multiplying the power and duration of the time when it is on. If the power is in watts and the time is in seconds, the energy will be in joules. In practice, electrical energy is measured in kilowatt hour. 1 kilowatt hour is known as 1 unit of electrical energy. Simply 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 1000 watt hour, or is equal to 1000 watt into 3600 seconds is equal to 3.6 into 10 power 6 joules. Students, and also we should understand, do you know how the Tamil Nadu government electricity working towards us? Solve the problem 2.15, then only we can understand the energy delivered during power. Also we should solve the problem 2.16, the relation between watt and power, energy and power, the voltage, like that. The next topic is electric cells and batteries. An electric cells or cell converts chemical energy into electrical energy to produce electricity. It contains two electrodes immersed in an electrolyte. Now we'll see the electric or chemical battery. This chemical battery or cell consists of positive terminal, negative terminal, cathode and anode, and also electrolyte. Several electric cells connected together form a battery. When these cells is connected to a circuit, electrons flow from the negative terminal to the positive terminal through the circuit. By using chemical reactions, a battery produces potential difference across its terminals. This potential difference provides the energy to move the electrons through the circuit. Commercially, available electric cells and batteries are shown. This is a simple cell. If we connect it one by one in series or parallel, we can call it battery. Next topic is electromotive force and internal resistance. Very important topic. A battery or cell is called a source of electromotive force, simply EMF. The term electromotive force is a misnomer since it does not really refer to a force but describes a potential difference in volts. The EMF of a battery or cell is the voltage provided by the battery when no current flows in the external circuit. So it is given in the diagram clearly. Let us see what is given measuring the EMF of a cell. Electromotive force determines the amount of work a battery or cell does to move a certain amount of charge around the circuit. It is denoted by the symbol psi and to be pronounced as psi. An ideal battery has zero internal resistance and the potential difference, that means terminal voltage across the battery, equal to its EMF. But a real battery is made up of electrodes and electrolyte. There is resistance to the flow of charges within the battery. This resistance is called terminal resistance, or for a real battery, the terminal voltage is not equal to the EMF of the battery. A freshly prepared cell has low internal resistance and it increases with aging. If keep on using the battery, it internal resistance will be increases, the delivering power is less. Now we move on the topic, determination of internal resistance. The circuit connections are made as shown in the figure. That means we have to connect battery, resistors and voltmeter in series, which shows one diagram, and another diagram, battery, resistors, these are all connected in series, but the voltmeter only have to connect or has to connect parallelly, which is shown another diagram. The EMF of a cell psi is measured by connecting a high resistance voltmeter across it without connecting the external resistance R. Since the voltmeter draws very little current for deflection, the circuit may be considered as open. Hence, the voltmeter reading use the EMF of the cell. Then, the external resistance R is included in the circuit and current I is established in the circuit. So, the potential difference across R is equal to the potential difference across the cell, which is clearly shown in the diagram 2.20b. Children, you see the diagram. By using books, you can understand clearly. The potential drop across the resistor R is V is equal to IR. That means potential relation V is equal to IR. Due to internal resistance R of the cell, the voltmeter reads a value V, which is less than the EMF of the cell psi. It is because certain amount of charges stopped by electrolyte, because the cell is made up of electrodes and electrolyte. The voltage, the amount of voltage IR has dropped. Then V is equal to psi minus IR. Therefore, IR is equal to psi minus V. Dividing the equation 2.36 by equation 2.35, we get IR by capital IR, psi minus V by V. Simply, internal resistance R is equal to psi minus V by V into R. Since psi and V and R are known, internal resistance R can be determined. We can also find the total current that flows in the circuit. Due to this internal resistance, the power delivered to the circuit is not equal to power rating mentioned in the battery. For a battery of EMF psi with an internal resistance R, the power delivered to the circuit of resistance R is given by P is equal to I psi is equal to I into V plus IR. Here V is the voltage drop across the resistance capital R and it is equal to IR. Therefore, power P is equal to I into IR plus I into R. therefore power P is equal to I square R plus I square small r. Here I square R is the power delivered to the internal resistance and I square capital R is the power delivered to the electrical device. Here it is the resistance capital R. For a good battery, the internal resistance R is very small. Then I square R very, very less than I square capital R and almost entire power delivered to the resistance. If you want to more about the internal resistance, we should solve the solved problem 2.17. For clear understanding, you should solve this solved problem by using the notes or rough works. Now we'll move. The next topic is cells in series. Several cells can be connected to form a battery. In series connection, the negative terminal of one cell is connected to the positive terminal of the second cell. The negative terminal of the second cell is connected to the positive terminal of the third cell, and so on. The free positive terminal of the first cell and the free negative terminal of the last cell become the terminal of battery. Suppose n cells, each of the EMF psi volts and internal resistance R ohms are connected in series with an external resistance R, which is given clearly in the diagram. What is the mechanism given by it? See children, the diagram. Batteries are connected one by one and also the respective circuit diagram and the psi value. The total EMF of the battery is equal to N psi. The total resistance in the circuit is equal to N R plus R. By Ohm's law, the current in the circuit is I is equal to total EMF by total resistance. That means N psi by N R plus R. Case A, if R is very, very less than capital R, then current I is equal to N psi by capital R. That means nearly N into I1, where I1 is the current due to a single cell. I1 is equal to psi by R. If small r is the negligible when compared to capital R, the current supplied by the battery is N times the R that supplied by a single cell. Case B, if R is very, very greater than capital R, then current I is equal to N psi by N R, nearly psi by R. It is the current due to the single cell. That is, current due to the whole battery is the same as that due to single cell, and hence there is no advantage in connecting several cells. We should understand the relations. The batteries are giving less or more current depending upon the internal resistance. Thus, series connection of cells is advantageous only when the effective internal resistance of the cell is negligible, small compared to or compared with capital R. Children, see that activity, you may understand this. And also, you should solve the problem 2.19, get more knowledge. Assignment is given. Please try to complete today itself. Thanking you.